Dear students, welcome to the video lecture of optional English class. This video lecture is intended for 5th semester optional English students, University of Mysore. In this video lecture, I shall discuss the novel The Rainbow, written by D.H. Lawrence. In this video lecture, I shall discuss the third chapter of the novel, that is Childhood of Anna Lensky. So let's know the summary of Childhood of Anna Lensky. Anna Lensky is the daughter of Lydia Lensky by her Polish husband Paul Lensky. So Anna Lensky is the daughter of Lydia and Paul. She is a child when she comes to live in the marsh farm with the Brangwens. So when she comes to the marsh farm, Anna is a little child. After the death of Paul Lensky, Lydia Lensky married Tom. So after the marriage, Lydia and Anna comes to live with the marsh farm. Therefore, Anna symbolizes the connection of the two worlds, the foreign Poland world and the rural English world. So she is the product of two different culture, that is Poland and England. In the beginning, Anna represented as a self-possessive child who follows her mother. She is initially detached from Tom. After the marriage, Lydia and Anna lives in the marsh farm. After her mother's marriage, Anna is described as a difficult child in the beginning. She resents that her mother sleeps with Tom during the night. It takes some time to take for granted that Tom is now her father. She continues to be a problem to all the people at the marsh. It is mentioned that there is something heartrending about her crying, since her childish anguish seemed so utter and so timeless, as if it were a thing of all the ages. She is described to be very happy, but she is quick, sharp, absurd, full of imagination and changeability. Tilly, the maid of Tom Brangwen, declares her to be a bewitched child. She gradually becomes more friendly with Tom. She draws near her stepfather and clings to him whenever she wants something. She often accompanies him to the town and feels comfort beside him. So the chapter implies that Anna doesn't become truly Brangwen, because initially Anna doesn't like Tom because Tom sleeps with her mother, and this irritates Anna very much. After some times, when Lydia gave birth to his son, Tom diverts his attention towards Anna because Lydia was full busy in caring of and nursing of their son. So Tom diverts his love and attention to Anna. She goes with him to the market and then to the public house. Anna becomes a known figure in the market and is treated by the farmers like a little heroine. So Anna and Tom relationship goes. Their bonding is become very intensive. Though this relationship is charged with much intensity, it lasts only for a short period, because after some time, Lydia again turns her attention towards Tom. She finds that Tom is detaching towards her. So at last she questions Tom why he is behaving like that. And Tom also finds that Lydia feels lonely, that's why she is quarreling with me. So finally they reconcile their quarrels and adjustment made there in their life. So to summarize the chapter, the third chapter describes the intensive bonding between Tom and Anna. And Tom enjoys the company of Anna. She draws near her stepfather and clings to him whenever she wants something. Anna and Tom has an element of Oedipal love. The significance of this chapter lies in the coming together of Tom and Lydia. So during Lydia's pregnancy and later during her preoccupation with a newborn child, Tom turns to his stepdaughter Anna. Anna and Tom has an element of Oedipal love. Their relationship between Tom and Lydia is tense, with each of them feeling rejected the other, but a loss to reconnect Lydia and later reconciliation. When she called, he answered. When he asked, her response came at once or at length. So far they were two separate things, but now there is growing awareness that they are really husband and wife. It is this successful adjustment that makes the Tom and Lydia relationship much more enduring than the other relationship depicted in the novel. So we come across the progressive relationship between Tom and Lydia in this chapter, and it can be said that Lawrence in this chapter made the husband and wife relationship and the marriage relationship is very intensive. It is common in the married life that both husband and wife get in quarrel, and after the quarrel they have some reconciliation, and the understanding between them will grow up. So this human psychology Lawrence introduced in this chapter, and as the novel told the story of three generation of Brangwyn family. So this is the Tom and Lydia's marriage life is a first generation of Brangwyn family. So according to Lawrence, this is the ideal married relationship comparing to the other generation of the Brangwyn family. So though they are belong to the two polarities, but they find uniteness and they find fondness in their relationship, and they live together. So that's all about this chapter. In the next video lecture, we will discuss the fourth chapter.